In this J1939 DBC file intro, we'll briefly explain the concept of the J1939 standard, DBC files, and how the J1939 DBC file can help you interpret CAN bus data from heavy-duty vehicles. In short, practically all vehicles today are based on CAN bus, aka the controller area network. The CAN bus enables communication between the electronic control units in the vehicle and ensures that information like speed, temperatures, RPM, fuel status, etc., can be shared on the network. In order to facilitate more advanced communication, various higher-layer protocols exist on top of CAN bus. For the vast majority of heavy-duty vehicles, the J1939 protocol serves as the standard. The implication is that the CAN bus data is encoded in a standardized way across trucks, transit buses, excavators, mobile cranes, and many other vehicles, regardless of the model, brand, or year. Essentially, you can record raw CAN bus data from practically any heavy-duty vehicle and use a consistent method to decode this data to human-readable form. Let's take an example. By using a CAN bus data logger like the CAN Edge, you can connect to a truck's CAN bus, typically through a J1939 Deutsch connector, an OBD2 connector, or in a contactless way. When you've recorded a log file of raw CAN data, you can open it in a software tool like the Assam MDF GUI. Here, you can review the raw data to see the timestamps, CAN IDs, and CAN data bytes. Raw J1939 data can typically be recognized by the fact that the CAN IDs are 29-bit in length and the data payloads are 8 bytes long. Now, obviously, the raw J1939 data is not very useful in itself. Rather, we need a way to decode the CAN IDs and data bytes into physical values, aka human-readable form. To do this, we can use a CAN database, also known as a DBC file. For the specific case of the J1939 standard, we offer a J1939 DBC file that contains the decoding rules for more than 12,000 parameters, also called SPNs or suspect parameter numbers. These SPNs are grouped in PGNs, aka parameter group numbers. For details, see our intro to the J1939 protocol. If you open the J1939 DBC file in a text editor, you'll see that it is simply a text file containing information on how parameters like engine speed are packaged within the data bytes of specific CAN frames. If we load the J1939 DBC file in the Assam MDF GUI software, we can decode the raw J1939 log file. The result is a new log file that now contains physical value data like engine speed, wheel-based vehicle speed, fuel rate, oil temperatures, and more. In the case of this particular truck, the raw CAN bus data contains around 100 unique CAN IDs. By using the J1939 DBC file, we managed to convert or match 70 of these CAN IDs, resulting in the extraction of more than 200 SPNs. In practice, there will always be some CAN IDs that cannot be matched with the J1939 DBC file, due to the fact that the original equipment manufacturers typically decide to encode some data in a proprietary way. If you are going to perform data logging across a fleet of trucks, buses, or construction vehicles, it's always a good idea to perform a test of what data you can decode early on. Because of this, we offer 100% free sample data conversions before you decide whether to purchase the J1939 DBC file. You can also use our online converter tool, where you can enter a list of CAN IDs to check if the corresponding PGNs are contained within the J1939 DBC file. To learn more about our J1939 DBC file, head over to our products page. You can also check out our intro to J1939 data logging and telematics using the CAN Edge. If you have any questions, please contact us for free technical sparring.